insurance.
But you're telling us that those who just
shop are enrolled. I have told you, sir, who is enrolled.
Okay, that's why we're frustrated because we just don't get
this
the truth out of you.
This isn't Medicare, and we
let
don't
me go to my next question.
In a government plan.
Let me go to my next question. The I had my phone on, and when my phone rang, I left it on because I wanted to talk to a Democrat state senator from my state of Illinois, who's on the Insurance Commission. And he said, and I quote, mandated preventive services are laid directly on premium prices. Now, so it's, you cannot say, as you had numerous times, that these preventative care services are, quote unquote, free of charge, can you?
They are free to the consumer, yes, sir.
They are not. There is no free lunch, Madam Secretary. If the premiums increase because of the mandated coverage based upon a state senator from the state of Illinois, a Democrat, who is in oversight of the insurance of the state of Illinois, and he says when you mandate coverage, it's rolled directly on premiums. As the premiums increase, that's paying for these services. You cannot say that these are free of charge.
Again, consumers will not have a copay or deductible, and I think that
will you admit they will have a higher premium?
If no, I do not. I think what a lot of actuaries will tell you is if you have preventive care and prevent a more costly hospital stay, cancer.
All right, I got it.
Down the line, that cost
we're just going to agree to disagree.
Lowers the premium, doesn't raise it.
It's like talking to the Republic of Korea or something.